Alright, just preparing for this week's shoot. This is for Lock It Up, the hip hop piece that is going to be rehearsed on Thursday night and then filmed on Saturday. I'm pretty stoked. Somehow, I got a group of very talented dancers to be a part of this. And not only this project, I also have a burlesque heels project that is being, it's in the works right now. And this is a moment where I cannot believe that I am able to believe in myself enough to put these projects together and make sure that they happen. When I first came up with these project ideas, I was like, it's something that I can try to make happen, but like, let's be honest, it's probably not going to, because I only know a couple of dancers in this area. And I don't know, I feel like nowadays, yes, collaborations are a thing and reaching out to strangers on social media is a thing, but there's so much of that going on that I think when people first start reading a message about like a collaboration, I feel like people's first instinct is to say no. It's like, like another person that wants me to be a part of something, you know? Especially because I was reaching out to some very talented people in this area, because there's a lot of talent in this dance community here. And so I'm like, these people are probably going to respond back with the typical response, sorry, I'm too busy, I can't do something that's unpaid. But to my shocking surprise, everyone said yes. There's only one person that wasn't able to do it, and literally it was just because in their schedule they just could not make it happen. I need to be choreographing a lot more, and I need to be teaching more, because I think if anything, I'm more of a teacher and a choreographer than I am a dancer myself. And on Wednesday, when I was doing that rehearsal for the paper bag dance, one of my friends came up to me and he was like, why are you not teaching? And I was like, nobody knows me in this area. Like, I am too afraid to go to dance classes. And I don't know how to dance on my own anymore. And so I was explaining that to him, and he was like, so? He's like, I'll come. Even if you only have like two people come, that's still you having a class and teaching. So he inspired me to go ahead and set up a class that I'm gonna teach on the last Thursday of this month before I leave Arizona for a while. And he made me realize that it really doesn't matter. I don't need a class that's full of like 15 to 20 people for it to be successful, you know? Like, even if only one person shows up, that's still a class, and I'm still able to teach and do what I love. So I appreciate that he said those things, because it meant a lot to me. It's funny how like your brain can start to believe things about yourself that aren't true. And I started to believe that I lost my ability to dance, I lost my ability to choreograph, which is dumb, because for a whole year now, I have been putting out dance videos, and a lot of those videos are my choreography. They are under my direction. And I look back on those videos and I'm very proud of them. I am. I remember back when Bury a Friend was filmed, and it was the first time I had worked with Lindsay, and I was telling her that I needed to build up my portfolio if I wanted to get film jobs. And she was like, well, perfect, I need to build up a portfolio of me dancing. And I was like, okay, cool. And Grub Web became a thing. And it's crazy that I didn't realize how much I was building my portfolio this whole past year, because my brain, I never think that anything is good enough. Like, anything that I do is good enough. And this brand that I've launched and that I'm trying to keep going forward with, it's making me realize how much I don't appreciate my work. And I need to. I don't ever give myself a break and realize that what I'm doing is good and the content that I put out there is good. And just because I get some negative feedback sometimes, it doesn't mean anything. It just means that that person didn't like it. It's because, surprise, not everybody has the same taste in this world. Not everybody likes the same things. Not everybody agrees on the same things. Not everybody has the same morals or ideas or ways of thinking. And that's why I just need to be happy with what I put out. And I think the reason that I wasn't appreciating my stuff is because I was looking at videographers that I follow and I'm like, my stuff just isn't as good as theirs. The reason I thought it wasn't as good as theirs is just because it wasn't the same camera that they used. I wasn't shooting the same angles that they were shooting. I'm so glad that I wasn't doing that because I am just shooting the way that I shoot. I'm shooting things how my brain sees it and I'm like, I'm gonna do that because I think that that's going to work for this video because I'm not those people that I see on Instagram and I don't want my work looking like everybody else's. So I stopped scrolling through Instagram. I don't do it. And it's because I don't want to see what other people are doing. I just do my own thing because I'm very much one of those people that will get caught up in watching other people's videos and I'll get into this hole of like despair and being like, my videos don't look like theirs, so my videos are not good. Why? Just because they have thousands of followers and I don't, and that makes it so that my videos aren't good? That's not the case. What I put out is good because I put my whole heart into it, and I give it my best, and I put it out there into the world, and that's that. That's all I can do. So, enough talking about me. I hope that by listening to me, I have like this realization that maybe some of you guys who are watching can realize that the things that you're doing in life are good. Even if it's not the same as somebody next to you, that doesn't mean that it's bad just because it doesn't look like the person next to you. It shouldn't look like the person next to you. We should all be doing our own things. Stop copying each other. It's good to get inspiration from each other. That's an amazing thing. It's amazing to be able to watch someone and to be so inspired by what they're doing. That is a great thing to be able to do. But what you're doing is good. Don't give up. Keep posting and keep working hard. Keep doing what you're doing because that's all that you can do. The online world is so competitive now, and really all that you can do is just post your content. If people like it, they're gonna follow you because they wanna see more. And that's that. Don't go buying followers. Don't bend over backwards trying to get people to view your things. Like, it doesn't matter. Just post your stuff, you know, and that's all. You don't need to be famous. You don't need any of that. All you need to do is just be proud of yourself. Keep posting. Because you never know who you're inspiring, how many people you're inspiring. You never know who's watching your content and you're helping them through something. You never know. So that's my 2 cents for today. I'm sorry that I haven't posted a vlog for like 2 days, I think. I did vlog on Friday. I'm just gonna put this out there. Friday was one of those days that I woke up and I was just in bed all day. It was a really hard day for me. I have days where mentally, I'm just not okay. And I know it. I did vlog all day. I was vlogging how I wasn't okay and how sometimes I have days where I feel like I'm getting so close to depression. And like all day, I'm just fighting to not cross that line into depression. And by the end of the day, I'm so exhausted. That was actually a day. It was that night. I was feeling all this pressure because I was so exhausted and I knew I needed to cry to let everything out, but like I hate crying, so I wasn't allowing myself. And it was probably like 9 p.m. or something, and I just took this speaker out into this living room and I turned the lights off because the speaker has like lights that flash. So I turned all the lights off and just had the light of like the speaker, and I turned on a Tash Sultana song because I really feel her music. It's so good. And I started dancing and I was bawling my eyes out while I was dancing. But after I did that, the reason I'm telling you guys this is because earlier I was saying how I felt like I can't dance anymore and like I can't choreograph, but I felt so freaking good about that improv that I did, and I didn't even go out there to try to like to whip out some amazing improv. Like I went out there just to like feel the music and let myself cry. And I realized, I was like, I'm putting way too much damn pressure on myself to try to like be good at freestyling again and be good at improvising and moving my body and like having great musicality, when like all I need to do, it's really simple actually, just turn the music on and just feel it and just dance and stop freaking putting pressure on myself that I have to have perfect freestyle and perfect this and perfect that. It's fine. Just turn the music on and feel it. Because that's why I started dancing in the first place. Because I didn't have like a great... I started dancing because I didn't know where else to put my emotions when I was growing up. So dancing helped me, and that's why I became a good dancer and really fast. Because all I cared about was just turning on music and dancing to it. That was always my favorite part of dance class growing up. It was just improv. My teachers would always turn the lights off and just let us feel the music and dance, and it felt so good. My teenager self not knowing what to do with my emotions. And sorry. I'm just like proud of myself because I've realized a lot this past week that I'm freaking talented, that I do know how to dance. And I'm a great teacher, and the content that I put out, it's good, and it's affecting more people than I think. So that's all that I have to say for today. I'm gonna try to get better at these vlogs, I promise. They are daily vlogs, and the reason I'm saying daily vlogs is because I'm trying to get it into my head that I need to vlog every single day, which means I need to post every single day. Just know that I'm just saying daily vlogs to motivate myself to eventually get to a point where I can post every single day. Anyway, thank you for watching, guys. Stay tuned for another vlog, hopefully tomorrow.